In this video, you can download the project to practice it right away. How to add Gamepad controller in Visual Scripting. You don't need to use Action Map or any C# as other people doing. Easy to get connected controller and know which one is playing. You can get any buttons from the controller and know when the button is pressed. Support most of controllers, Gamepad, Joystick, Nintendo Switch. Gamepad controller is never easier than before in Visual Scripting. You can download this project folder free with link under video. Open it with Unity 2021 or newer version. After open, you can play it immediately. First, we need to add new input system. If older version, you can press here to see the newest version. The current newest version is 1.6.1. Copy this name to install it. And add the version you want to install in. Next, you need to add controllers you want the game to play with. This is the old input system, and this is the new one. After exporting, only these controllers can play your game. Let's add Gamepad controller. On player settings, you can enable to use both new and old input system. But after exporting, only new input system can work. I play in with the old input system now. Next, let's connect your Gamepad controller to your computer. To be able to get button events, you must do this. We need to add input system events to our Visual Scripting node. Add Gamepad events to. Button control event to know when the button is pressed. If your game uses joystick controller, you must add it here. Or this controller event for Nintendo Switch. One more, Dpad control to get button left, right, up and down on Gamepad. Open player controller script. This is the basic player controller we made already in last video. Let's add new Gamepad controller events here. First, we need to get which controller and how many are connected. Use input system get devices. This event will return all connected controllers currently. let's add numbers of connected controllers into a variable. If there is any connected controllers, this value will be greater than 0. Next, create new variable for the current gamepad controller. Gamepad 1 will be always the gamepad that player 1 is playing. It will be always the first connected controller. If your game has two controllers for two players, add one more gamepad 2 for player 2. Gamepad 2 will be always the last connected controller. But we don't need it now, we will do it in next video, two players. Next, let's use button left, right of gamepad to move player. There are all buttons on the gamepad controller here. Dpad is for button left, right, up and down. Use button right to move player to right. But we need an input gamepad to tell which gamepad buttons are pressing. If button is pressing, move player to right or left. Let's copy these events and disable keyboard buttons. Replace button D with button right from gamepad. Button control to tell button is pressing or pressed down or up. Is pressed means button is pressed and holding. We need to check if there is any gamepad controller connected first. If button right is pressing, player move to right. Do the same for button left. No buttons are pressing. Player will play animation idle. Press play to test it. Buttons work perfect. Search for jump event. button is pressed, player will jump. Disable the keyboard button and copy this event. I use this gamepad button check again. Now, let's get button B from gamepad to do player jump. If button B is pressed down, player jump. We finish button jump event. It worked perfect with gamepad controller. Search for run event. If button run is pressing, do running event. Disable keyboard button and copy this event. Do the same to check button on gamepad. This time, use button Y for player run. If button Y is pressed and holding, player is running. If button Y is not pressed, turn off running. We have finished button run event. Press play. Player will run faster if button Y is pressing. We finish all the buttons for our character. Gamepad controller is never easier than before in visual scripting. When you spot it, it works perfect too. Next video, let's use two gamepad controllers for two players in this game. See you in next video. Thank you for watching.